Hey, Sean Jantz here, and do a quick Ben a plan for Thursday, October 31st, Halloween, and I'm going to do it on /ES, which is the S&P 500 and the other indices that you can find on Nadex. And I'm going to start here on /ES, and I'm actually starting tonight again on the daily time frame, which is what I call the Eagle View. And I just want to make sure, because I want to show this daily chart, because I want to make sure everybody understands what's going on here in the bigger picture, the larger time frame. And so just a little bit of a recap, just in case you haven't been watching, right? This daily chart actually, pretty much since the summer of 2019, has been cycling really well. Oversold, overbought, oversold, overbought, oversold, right? You can see the cycles here as well. And so where are we now? What are we? We're actually severely, severely overbought. All-time highs. We're being elevated and pushed up multiple reasons right now. Okay, you got the positive China trade talk. We got positive, mostly, there's some negatives, but there's a few negative companies, but mostly positive earnings. And then we just had the Fed funds cut rates again, 0.25%, which is very positive for the stock market. So that's what's happening right now. And since I've been doing this for so long, this is just kind of how the market moves in terms of the bulls will just do this really slow, like pull your hair out grind to the upside. You can kind of see that visually. And then what happens is we see a release of bearish, or I guess if you want to call release of bullish pressure by seeing the bears, when they dump, they freaking drop hammer. You can see some of these days were very, very sharp to the downside, and it's to the bears, right? And so that day is coming. So I'm just letting you know, I want to make sure that nobody's caught off guard, that we're likely going to see a dump in this market once some of this positive fundamentals kind of relax. I can't imagine a lot of these people here are going to be taking profits, and that also induces sellers in the market as well. Okay, so there's some negatives happening here. 33,055, that is all-time high, all time, since the beginning of forever. We're now entering levels of the charts where price has never been ever. So at least on this chart, right? A couple of the others, RTY and Dow Jones are a little better, but at least on this chart, we have zero structure, none. Right? And so we're going to need, this will likely not be my favorite chart for tomorrow, because I always want to trade where there's structure, because that helps gauge and aid where the highest probability trades are going to lie. Well, if there's no structure, it's extremely, extremely difficult. Move here to the 4-hour chart. We kind of zoom in. You can see, obviously, we're overbought. We are starting to build a little bit of sideways change control here. You move here to the 15-day, 15-minute plot chart, you can see this incredibly slow bullish grind to the upside, right? And we kind of, once we had the Fed funds rate come out today, kind of shot this chart higher. You can see we hit all-time high at 30.55, kind of sold off a little bit. Now we're just kind of chilling right here at this, and I would call this a supply zone, right? So if then we play that game. What if it goes higher? What if it goes lower? Well, if it goes higher tomorrow, I'm not doing anything on this chart. And I'm not saying that you can't. And if I were to do something, I'd look for change control, either at plus 0.5 or plus 1 for sell triggers. But there's no structure to the left since forever. And so that just lowers the probability of success. I always want to be trading where there's structure to the left. And this chart just doesn't have it. There's other charts. There's better charts out there if it goes higher. If it goes lower, okay, there is that concept of value-rated drift back. It's not huge. Okay, but it is roughly about 8 points possible, or maybe, yeah, eight to almost 10 points worth, the value rate drift back. And so that concept basically is when price finishes away from the brand new value rate box. More times than not, nothing's 100%, but price will want to retrace back at least at a minimum to back into VA high. Or if it's the same thing, if it finishes here up into VA low. And so you wouldn't sell just yet. I would use, obviously, you can see 30.45 is a pretty decent line in the sand. If these bears can break this and then hold lower highs, you can you could use first TP into value high, and then you can lock and trail for Wednesday negative 0.5 if you're doing traditional futures or touch brackets. Again, this may be difficult to catch. It's not huge. and it may just kind of get through and tank, and then there's no lower highs, so that happens. But just kind of sharing with you that concept there. If this market really, really, really dumps, there could be an opportunity for an 80% roll back down into this value rate low, negative one, Monday POC. You can see the demand structure here, consolidation structure there. I personally don't think that this will happen. It is fairly rare to see this strong of fundamental money to the upside and then 24 hours later dump back. Typically what happens is you see something like this. You see the push up and then you kind of see a day like this, right? Kind of build structure. And then the following 48 hours, maybe even 72, then we see the cycle back, okay? But I'm just telling you more times than not, this is the pattern that it does. But you can be possibly prepared. If it starts breaking, strong volume, holding lower highs, could be an opportunity for 80% roll if it's a good pullbacks. If I were to buy this chart, I'm definitely not buying here, not at almost all-time high. That's silly. I'm not saying that you can't. I'm just, no way would I buy there. And it may hold. I'm just telling you that I like my money. I want to put it in higher probability levels. This one isn't terrible. I mean, at a minimum, I mean, obviously this chart's severely bullish, right? So if I do buy this chart, I want to make sure that I'm buying some deep, good pullbacks, and I would find change control. And then the next structure actually isn't even down here until into that 3000, which is roughly a negative two deviation. Session Q is almost the exact same. One better thing about it is that it has a larger opportunity for the value area drift back. Larger profit potential for the value area drift back opportunity. That's how I should have said that. And so I wouldn't sell just yet. Same concept. You would need to see a breakout. You might have to make sure that these bears are showing strength first. Then you can start holding lower highs. I would use a with this pretty large of a opportunity, I would use quarter deviation for first TP, and then you can lock and trail right there. I personally not going to look for buy triggers till a minimum here. I don't even know if that I would buy that, but I would need to see good change control, and then you don't have demand until you get back down into that negative two. Slash YM, actually, it's pretty much the exact same. If you go to the bird's eye view on slash YM, though, here's what's different. What's different is that the bird's eye view, we're not at all-time highs on slash YM. This has structure at the plus 0.5, and then it has supply structure here from July at the plus 1. So if the indices as a whole go higher, this is the one that actually has structure. So this will be the one that I look for. This has the same concept for possible value rate drift back. I wouldn't be super greedy for the negative 0.5. I would lock and trail into value area high. And then slash RTY, definitely quite a bit different than the other three. Slash RTY, same thing, is not at all-time highs. It will have structure at plus 0.5. It will have structure at plus 1. It'll also have structure at the 1600. 1600 was a pretty good magnet this summer, or supply level, I guess, if you want to say. If this goes higher, it has very obvious fine change control. And then you got the plus 1, and then you got the 1600. As far as to the downside, value rate low and negative 0.5, it's not terrible for first buy trigger, but this chart is pretty overbought in the larger time frames. It still has a lot of room to cycle lower. So I think if I buy this chart, I'm going to need to see some pulling back. What used to be short-term resistance, breakout, and then became support right there on Sunday night, Monday. That can now become a target and possible support. And then we have a second layer of demand kind of sitting here, which is close to that negative 1.5, negative 2. So I hope that we get dumps in this market because we need it. We need to release this bullish pressure, especially in ES and in Q. It is extremely, extremely difficult to day trade at all-time highs like this. We need better two-sided price action. We need a volatility pop. If you go to the VIX right now, which measures volatility, I mean, it went down 7% today. I mean, it's literally just as low as it can almost get, right? But what's cool about the VIX, okay, is this is one of the single greatest overbought, oversold indicators. And so when the VIX gets oversold, Okay, and you can see how it's coming into a super, super, super strong demand level for 2019. This chart is negatively correlated to /ES. So notice you would call this pretty much a buy trigger, right? You can see that massive demand level. So if this goes higher, ES goes lower, right? So that's why I'm still short in my stock options, because I'm anticipating the VIX to get a pop. And when the VIX goes higher, we see volatility increase, and then we also see the indices go lower, okay? So be prepared. This is what I'm talking about. VIX is extremely, extremely low right now, almost at the yearly lows. This is when you get kind of slower grind movements, but we're due for a VIX pop. And when the VIX pops, price is going to move much faster, okay? Which is what we want and what we need. So I'm excited to get this VIX to pop again, okay? So don't forget that we also have deviations on the four major Forex pairs. Because of FOMC, the four major Forex pairs are making some significant moves. All of them, though, have bird's eye view structure, so that's good. Could be some opportunity tonight, even a London session. And then we got Valuraya and deviations on crude oil. And then this one here is just an empty one for anything else that you want to trade, such as Euro Yen, Pound Yen, Aussie Yen, Dollar Swiss, Dollar CAD, what have you. Okay, so there's 9 charts to trade with. There's always action somewhere. Message me or Ryan Smith if you have any questions. Take pictures of all of your trades and post them in the group and in the chat room so that you can get feedback from me and from others.